Hi guys, Pastor Beth here. Hope you are enjoying or enjoyed week one of our virtual vacation Bible school, that you were able to do some of the activities or maybe the exercises that were on the video or that you listened to, or maybe you even read our story from last week and maybe you sang the song as well. So we're talking about compassion because it's called Compassion Camp, right? So what does compassion mean to you? I hope you can answer that, or maybe you can tell your parent or your grandparent or your friend what compassion means. But part of what compassion means, it means caring for others, not just in our hearts and our minds, but also doing something in our actions that helps their situation. Either maybe helps them feel better or alleviate some pain or something they're going through. So last week we talked about compassion for ourselves, being compassionate to ourselves. It means taking care of ourselves and getting rest and speaking positive things both to us and to others. So this week we're going to continue talking about compassion, but this week we're talking about compassion with the world. So not just ourselves, not just our neighbors, but with the world, all the world that God created. So let's begin with a prayer this morning. Joyful Spirit, your loving hands are always creating freedom, release, and fresh starts. Help us to do the same today by caring for all living things with gentleness and care. Open us to humbly receive that same care ourselves. Make our hearts smile and our actions sing with your promise of abundance towards the whole world. Amen. So just like last week, we have a song also for this week, and it's called A Compassion Prayer. I read it in our service on Sunday. We didn't have it sung, but Susan's going to share that song with you in just a moment. But as we think about this compassion, there are times that I kind of feel a little overwhelmed with things, right? Do you ever feel overwhelmed by things? Maybe it's pressures from school or working on a project that I just can't seem to get right, and I feel overwhelmed sometimes. And when I feel that way, I want to start over. I want a fresh start. I want the chance to try again and make everything right. So have you ever had an opportunity to start over on a project that felt overwhelming? Fresh starts feel good, and when we have a fresh start, we are hopeful about the next step. So before we get to our story, let's hear a song first. This song is called Compassion Prayer. I hope you like it.
Filled up to the top of our hearts when we have the power
Well, welcome back, and I hope you like that song. It's titled Compassion Prayer, because being in prayer is something very important that we can do to be compassionate, and then we need to follow it up with actions. And one of the activities this week is to make a prayer flag. So you should have gotten one of these in your kits, but we have some extra at church as well. And so then you write your prayer for the world in permanent marker that's in your kit on this flag. And then we're going to tie them up at church. There's some up there now. There's a string out front by the sign. And so after you've written your prayer for the world, I want you to tie this up on that string so your prayer joins others, so that we surround the world with prayer. So that's a good activity for this week. And as we continue to think about compassion for the world, we come to our story from Leviticus, which is in the Old Testament, and it's Leviticus 25, chapter 25. And the Israelites had been freed from slavery in Egypt, right? And they traveled for a long time and many years to the land that God had promised them. The journey of God's people in the wilderness is kind of the setting for this story. And so we're going to learn an important, wonderful tradition for God's people. It's called Jubilee. It's a way of starting over. When we are given a fresh start, we see and feel and trust how God's abundance is meant for all people and creation. As you listen to the story today, think about what it is like to have a fresh start. So here's our story. The people of Israel journeyed through the vast wilderness for many years. Finally, they arrived at Mount Sinai, where they rested. God gave instructions to their leader, Moses, for their life together in this new land. And these were the things that God said. In this land, we will practice Sabbath together. This will happen not only on the seventh day, but on the seventh year. For 6 years, we will do our regular work and plant seeds. We'll grow and prune and harvest fruit. But in the seventh year, we'll let the land rest. Even the land needs peace and quiet. Everyone will be able to harvest and eat whatever the land gives us in that seventh year. And then in the 50th year, we will celebrate Jubilee together. This will be like the Sabbath every 7 years, where we'll let the land rest. It will be a fresh start for the whole community, the land and the people, and everyone will go to their own homes and be together in joy. It is a holy time, and we will be fed and nourished by whatever the land gives. In this time, we will respond with justice by giving fresh starts. This means that we will be fair and honest to one another. We will take care of others who are sick, alone, old, or need help. We will welcome people who are from different countries, and they will be like family. We will work for people's freedom. We will work together to help everyone rest and rejoice in God's abundance. I will bless the land during this year, so you do not have to work the land. I promise we will all be fed and nourished by the land's gifts. This is the story of God for God's people. So as you heard that story about rest and renewal, not just on the seventh day, but on the seventh year, and then again on a Jubilee year, the 50th year, what were some of the things that God wanted the Israelites to do? And why do you think God asked them to do it? Can you imagine how the people of Israel felt about this command? And what does it mean, or what does it feel like to rest? I know when my kids were little, I'd when they were very little, they took naps. But then as they got older, then they didn't take naps so much. But they get tired and cranky. So I said, well, if you can't take a nap, then just go rest. So it's a way of refreshing yourself and renewing yourself. And it's kind of like having a fresh start. So why do you think it's important to have a fresh start? All these things that God has called us to do, to think about and to reflect on how we rest and renew and have fresh starts, and then how we can be compassionate with the world, not just with other people, but compassionate to the earth and God's good creation. So I hope you explore some of the activities this week. I hope you do the prayer flag. I hope to see a lot of them hanging up there. They're very colorful. And then on this video also, you can see the exercises that were done by my good friends, Nancy and Jessica, and I thank them for sharing their video with us. So go this week and be kind, be loved, and be you.
As we've been learning, breathing is the heart of yoga. And today's breath yoga sequence will be connecting our bodies with compassion's gift of fresh starts. Sit on the floor with your legs crossed. Take three deep, slow breaths. Inhale, I am a part. Exhale of God's balance and fresh starts. Inhale, I am a part. Exhale of God's balance and fresh starts. Inhale, I am a part of God's balance and fresh starts. Slowly rise, stand in mountain pose, arms straight and strong by your side, feet firmly planted on the ground. One big breath in, one big breath out. In mountain pose, we feel our strength. We are unshakable. Reach your arms up to the sky, then back down as you bend into forward fold, hands on the ground or resting on your shins wherever it's comfortable. Take a breath in and raise your hands to your knees, head looking forward. We prepare and focus our eyes forward. Take a breath and put your hands back to the ground in forward fold. From forward fold, jump both legs back or step one leg and then the other into plank pose. Lower further to the ground. Straighten your arms and stretch your upper body, head toward the sky into upward facing dog. We'll hold this position while breathing in and out a few times. We face the sun and welcome with courage what this day holds for us. From upward facing dog, lower your body back to the ground and push your legs up into downward facing dog. Raise your right leg up and step it forward into a lunge, foot between your hands. Raise your upper body, arms to the sky, chest and face forward into warrior one. Square your shoulders to the left and extend your arms out wide, parallel to the ground, palms facing down in warrior two. We'll take a few breaths, eyes looking over your right hand. In warrior two, we open our arms to make room for everyone and everything. We stretch to see what's beyond us. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, circle your arms down to the floor, one at either side of your right foot, and step your right foot back to meet the left. Move into downward facing dog. Now we're going to repeat the same sequence on the left side. Raise your left leg up, then step it forward into a lunge, foot between your hands. Raise your upper body, arms to the sky, chest and face forward into warrior one on the other side. Square your shoulders to the right and extend your arms out wide, parallel to the ground, palms facing down in warrior two. Take a few breaths, eyes looking over your left hand. In Warrior Two, we open our arms to make room for everyone and everything. We stretch to see what's beyond us. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, circle your arms down to the floor, one on either side of your left foot. Step your left foot back to meet the right. Move into downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, jump both feet forward or step one foot then the other to meet your hands. Slowly roll your back up until you're standing straight and tall in mountain pose. Standing in mountain pose, shift your weight to your left foot. Bring your right foot to the inner side of your left leg. Ankle, calf, or inner thigh, whatever feels comfortable. Toes pointing toward the ground. Let yourself lengthen and feel your spine stretch upward. Press your right foot into your left leg and bring your hands into prayer form by your heart. Focus your eyes on a still point and balance now in tree pose. Tree pose teaches us to be patient, steady, and balanced. A tree lives in rhythm with the world and its cycles. It nourishes all living things. Lower your right foot to the ground, then repeat on the other side. Shift your weight to your right foot and bring your left foot to the inner side of your right leg, ankle, calf, or inner thigh, whichever feels comfortable. Toes pointing to the ground. Press your left foot into your right leg and bring your hands into prayer form by your heart. Focus your eyes on a still point and balance now in tree pose. Try and hold for three big breaths. Tree pose teaches us to be patient, steady, and balanced. A tree lives in rhythm with the world and its cycles. It nourishes all living things. Lower your left foot to the ground and stand in mountain pose. Reach your arms up to the sky, then draw them into prayer form right by your heart. End with a bow of your head and your hands as you share the foundational yoga greeting, Namaste. A call to see one another the way God sees each of us. The light in me sees the light in you.